So imagine a Christmas carol, but just really phony. Hello everyone, welcome to Movie Reviews by Josh. My name is Josh Terry, and today I'm going to be talking about a recent movie called Collateral Beauty, starring Will Smith, that frankly is one of the more disappointing movies of the Christmas season. This movie is a little bit like A Christmas Carol, the old Charles Dickens story, only instead of three ghosts, imagine if the three actors were hired by some legal team to try to make a case against Ebenezer Scrooge. And also if Ebenezer Scrooge was a parent mourning the loss of his six-year-old daughter. So if that makes you feel a little bit creepy, then you understand how I felt while watching this movie. Okay, so Will Smith, the Howard character, is an advertising executive, and he builds all of his campaigns on people's relationships with death and time and love, and says that all of our feelings, all of our emotions, all of our motivations are connected to those three things, which kind of backfires on him when his child dies, and we jump ahead 2 or 3 years later and see him in a state where he's just kind of regressed within himself, and he's depressed and he's cut off from things. Now, Howard has become so withdrawn into himself that he's on the verge of losing his ad agency. And so his coworkers come up with a plan to try to kind of knock him back into shape and get his head on straight. And their plan is to hire three local actors to portray death and time and love, to try to encounter him out on the street and make him think that all these things that he's taken for granted are real, and hopefully that will get him back on track and that will save the agency and all of their jobs. Because since that sounds like such a heartless thing to do, we also have to have a bunch of different peripheral storylines for each of his coworkers that show that, you know, one of them's dealing with cancer, another one is trying to decide whether to get a sperm donor and have a child, and one is dealing with a divorce. There's all these different plot lines and storylines, and they all kind of come centered around this, basically this scam. And now I will tell you that they try to resolve this in a positive way, and they try to make the best out of the situation. The trouble is that for the majority of the movie, you're just not seating comfortably with what is happening, and what is happening especially to Howard. Because if this movie had been presented with more of a lighthearted tone, I'm thinking about Heart and Souls from the early 1990s with Robert Downey Jr., if it had been a little bit more lighthearted, a little more comic, I think they could have gotten away with it. They could have been able to justify what's happening. The problem is that Will Smith is just doing too good of a job of being depressed and emotional and despondent. And because of that performance, you look at what everybody else is doing and just think, this is awful. I can't believe that they're doing this. In the meantime, he's trying to work his way into a support group for grieving parents that's run by Naomi Harris. And yet another example of a fine cast member, and that's really one of the things that makes this movie a disappointment, is they have this incredible cast, and especially in Will Smith's case, some great performances that just go for naught because the story and the tone and the execution just really, really doesn't work. This movie comes from David Frankel, who is the guy who is behind Marley and Me. He also did Devil Wears Prada. This is not going to be considered one of his triumphs. Now again, when you step back from it a little bit, you know what they're getting at. You understand what they're trying to do, what they're trying to say. The problem is, it's just not working. The execution is just not there. And for that reason, I'm gonna wind up giving this one only about 2 stars out of 4. They have some good intentions, but the execution, and it probably sounded good on paper and just doesn't work very well in reality. This is a PG-13 movie. It has the one obligatory F-bomb and some language. There's really nothing else besides that in terms of content that's going to be very offensive. But honestly, it's not the content that is the problem with this one. So thanks again for joining me. Again, this is Movie Reviews by Josh. It's been fun having you. Be sure to subscribe on your way out and always keep your notifications on so that you can see our new videos as soon as they're posted.